Hello there, this is Makoto from Makoto's World and welcome back to another Star Wars video. Always on Wednesday, when I have the time, I will do a Star Wars video. This is my Star Wars movie film ranking, and for that I will use a tier list. So this is my personal taste and my thinking about the movies. I'm not a person who hates something. When I don't like a movie or a thing, I don't watch it. And when you don't know it, tier list basically from S to D, you rank things. Mostly in characters, anime characters or superheroes, after their powers, after their how strong they are. In this case, it's about the movies, what is amazing, what amazing scenes are there, or powerful scenes, the characters and entire story, what is important. Every Star Wars movie, the six Star Wars movies are important, but you know what I mean. It's more about little things that change it, and it's from S to D, so it's wide spectrum. We start with Star Wars Episode 2, Attack of the Clone. We start with good thing or things that happen in movies are important. Of course, the entire conflict, galactic war happened, the KOS getting more, buying attacks, and everything. The Clone Wars starting on Kamino, the entire thing. Kamino, I love Kamino. Kamino, one of my favorite planets. That's why it's high up. I love the Kaminianas. It's just amazing concept. Jango Fett with Obi-Wan. There, also how even Ian said that he like a detective in the behind the scenes. It's like, you know, Obi-Wan was there like a detective finding out who is behind this attack, and then of course on Tatooine, on Geonosis. The Jedi battle of Mace Windu, yeah. Samuel Jackson going in action. This party is over. So, of course, Sir Christopher Lee. I mean, this is also what I say. All the actors are perfect. Hayden, also. I love all of them. They all really are the characters. When I see them, I see the characters too. So, entire Jedi battle. The end, of course, with Yoda. Yoda and Dooku fight, and from the dialogues, from the romantic thing, of course, this is where I say it will be not on top, but it is so full of amazing things. Moving on, Star Wars Empire Strikes Back. One of my favorite movies just because it's so dark. Episode 4 is iconic, but it's not, oh my gosh, like episode 2 or 3. But episode 5 is so dark. I mean, in Hoth, first thing you see is Luke almost getting killed. This is the first thing we have on Hoth. Luke almost gone killed, and then the rebels in attack from Vader and Co. And Vader first appearance, Vader with his fleet, and he is evil and killing his commanders. And of course, Han and Leia. Of course, the romantic relationship. There were not so much cheesy dialogue, but it is, yeah. On Dagobah, we met him first time. Original Yoda, Luke and Yoda, he learned about to become a Jedi, and the entire Bespin fight, Lando Calrissian. Bespin is also one of my favorite cities. It's so the music, I love the music. We don't need to talk about the music. In all movies, the music is just, it's just incredible. Without the music, it wouldn't be so amazing. So yeah, on S, it is so amazing. The end fight, Luke Vader. I freaking love it. I just love it. Boba Fett's first experience and Han going carbonite. So it's so a dark movie. It's really, when you put it for Star Wars, it's really dark and it's so depressing. Because you see always the heroes getting hit. The Force Awakens. I must say, of course, the first one, I liked it. Because it was new, it was Star Wars up again. But in the end, it was like, of course, episode 4, a lot of people say, with another bad guy and everything, the characters. But it was the first thing, and it was hyped, it was new, and it's really the effects, everything, the music, it's great, so I put it on B. Because it's not, it never will be high up, but it's not that bad. It was the first movie for that. It was, okay, it was alright. It was alright. Yeah, this, I haven't seen it yet. I put it just down here. I just put it down here because I don't have seen it. Episode 4. I must say, it's on B. Episode 4 for me is on B. It's an amazing movie. It's the first movie, but it, for me, it's a long. It takes a long time to move on. One from the fast. It's very slow movie, you can say. We have just one planet. We're just Tatooine the entire time. Then we have the Death Star, Yavin. We see a little bit, and it's not much going on. We're just on Tatooine and have that going on, and then going for. Up and down, then we go into the Death Star, and so, of course, when the first time watched it, but in the end, it's important for the plot and the amazing characters, the Vader and everything. Luke, for me, it's not something I have seen all movies multiple times, but this is not a movie I would watch now when I notice more, because it's just we watch it one time and okay, this is how the movie for me is. It's an amazing movie, but it's not really say this is top. Episode 5 is top S. Episode 1, I put it also on B. I put it on B because it's not even mean rude or something, but I really fall asleep in the movie. I watched this also 6-7 times, so I really watch the movies multiple times. I'm really a big fan of this, and I always the first or second time okay. But then I really fall always asleep because in the end it's action, a fight with Maul and everything, but before that it's not so much going on, of course, in the first thing, then Naboo, Jar Jar, Mise Da, and so Anakin, important character, Qui-Gon Jinn, about the Queen Naboo, but it's not from a story, it's important because we learn about Anakin. It's B, but it's the Darth Maul, of course, important character. It has seen, but you could, to make it sound like that, you could put this movie on 10 minutes. You put all important scenes in it that help. And this is how it is for me. So put the first thing, Naboo, a little bit Tatooine, but then go to the fight already. So all the rest is important, but for me, movie has not so much thing where say, oh, I have to watch it. Episode 6. In Jabba's place, hello, this is Luke badass coming in, everything, of course. It is on the second place. It's just amazing. First time we see Emperor, we see fight. It is more, it's intense in the way because it's the revenge of everything, and we learn about Luke and Leia. And then, of course, the fight between Luke and Vader, and then the Emperor getting killed, Death Star again, on Endor. It's amazing movie. It has a lot of important scenes again. It's the end of everything, but it's not like Episode 5. 5 is different. This is more like, okay, the end of everything. That's why I put it on A. Rogue One. I freaking love Rogue One. I watched this and really was always hyped and excited. It was really one of my favorite movies. I really watch it. I like the characters all. Sadly, they all died, but of course, I like the entire concept. Also, everything was new with the technology and everything. With Tarkin looked really from a video game. I thought, wait a minute, he looks a little bit weird, and yeah, it was CGI. And of course, the end with Vader. This was the best. This is really what I love about this movie. This movie really shows this, even though it's a little one, but and so many great scenes, fight scenes, and for me, it was a really amazing way with action. It was also a standalone for me because they're all characters we don't know, besides Leia and Vader. But this everything is so it's something new. It's something that's not from the story, so it's okay. That's why it's okay because it's not something that's. You know how it's continue and so it's yeah it has different vibe because all these characters are new and so you don't know it and it was something refreshing. I don't have to think much. Episode 3 and 5, my two favorite movies, Star Wars movies, but episode 3 the best. It is so good, so many good fights, so many freaking things happened, everything. General Grievous, one of my favorite characters, is there. And Dooku, of course, again, fight gets killed, and Palpatine and then Jedi is getting killed, and of course it's the beginning. We see how Anakin becomes Vader and end fight Anakin versus Obi-Wan, so badass, and Yoda versus Sidious, Mace Windu versus Palpatine. It's so much going on in this movie. It's the best for me. It's so great. The music again is great. The entire story, it's so intense and sad, and every time when the Jedi's all die, this music can make gives me every time goosebumps. I love it. It's really, really one of the best movies they've made. And I watched the behind the scenes, but when you see it, you love it even more. How much details, how much thinking they put into it. And when you think about that, that movie normally would be much, much longer. They cut a lot of out, so it's freaking amazing. Solo, I put it on C because I haven't seen it. But it's again, it's a standalone film. It's The Last Jedi. I don't even care. It's on D. On D. So, yeah. I think this really is how I have seen it. Here we are. Thank you very much for watching this. I think I never talk too much, but Star Wars is my thing. So I really, about Star Wars, I can talk hours and hours. That's why I do this day, because it's really how I feel. And yeah, what are your favorite Star Wars movies? I would like to know, and that's my list. And definitely, I'm excited to do more stuff with Star Wars. So we see us next time. And may the force be with you. Bye-bye.